First, soy and all its bodies get sucked in an intake valve and sent all the way to their unique drinking water treatment facility. But not just one valve, but a couple, to collect water from different depths and different temperatures. Let's call this water raw water, meaning the original water without any separation techniques. Second, the raw water is brought two pipes into a holding area, either a large tank or small reservoir, to number one, to screen the water for any large floating objects such as fish, fine solids, or debris. And number two, the screened water just sits in the holding area until most of the silt and clay particles are all settled to the bottom. Third, the water is pumped into concrete steel sediment basins from 8 to 20 feet deep. In these deep basins, various chemicals are added to the water to suspend even finer matter, including fire acids, to form a gelatinous mass at the bottom called flock. The flock is removed every 6 months. If this step, called flocculation, coagulation, doesn't remove any excessive organic material, then two additional steps called pre-chlorinating and pre-ozonation will be needed. The third step could be eliminated and go straight to this step, which is called filtration, if the raw water was protected. And yes, it means that the water passes through a medium of sand and gravel in order to get the last bits of contaminants or foreign matter out. The filtered water goes straight into another storage tank. The second to last step is called fluoridization, which sodium fluoride is added to improve the health of your teeth. The last and final step varies in order to disinfect for bacteria and viruses. From chlorination, ozone gas, UV systems, pH, to corrosion.
All right, the moment you've all been waiting for. Soy and all of its now drinkable bodies can ride a long pipe highway straight into your house. Not quite. The now treated water goes into a storage unit, usually a water tower, at a high point through a water pipe to maintain water pressure. When you open the tap, the amount of water stored in there depends on various factors, such as time of day, water consumption, water pump power, flow rate, and of course, the size of the unit.
The water then goes down towards your house to be available for you by having pipes in one of four configurations. When it lands into your house, it uses one of two systems, indirect or direct. Indirect is where your main line is separate from the storage system. Direct is where the main line branches off to different parts of the house, depending where the sinks are, including entering the hot water boiler. Finally, the water comes out. That's good and all, but you might heard of words thrown around, such as hot water and soft water. What's that? Hot water contains a higher concentration of dissolved minerals, mostly calcium, while soft water contains a lower concentration or none at all. Both of them have their pros and cons, but the best for drinking and most natural would be hard water. Despite many people preferring soft water because of the filtering factor, so it is settled, soy is hard water. Now soy can go through your faucet and... oh no! That's some good tasting water. I wonder what it took to be like that.